Hi everyone, this video is called The Jesuit Priesthood of Lucifer, and it's been a week since I brought a webcam on YouTube and I've had people asking me would I bring some more. Well, this video is about the Jesuits worshipping Lucifer, and I'm going to begin by talking about Jesuit controlled Hollywood. And what I'm going to do in this video, in the description section of the video, I'm going to leave some links so that you can look at these videos if you want to. You don't have to, but if you want to, they're there. And of course, you can watch these videos. Now, the first video I'm going to talk about is a video called The Rite. It was brought out in 2011, and it was played by Anthony Hopkins. He's a very good actor. And the plot was really a man named Michael who was training to be a priest. And of course, he lacked strong faith in Catholicism. He was lacking faith. And so he was sent to a Jesuit priest, obviously Anthony Hopkins, who performed exorcisms, and he failed, really. And he was called Father Xavier, of course, you know, very high Jesuit priest. And what happened was, through multiple sessions, these people were not delivered. But what happened was, at the very end of the video, you had this man, Michael, who was being trained by a Jesuit priest, Anthony Hopkins. He eventually saw real demonic exorcisms, in the sense that he saw Anthony Hopkins become possessed by the devil. And of course, remember that in this video, this man is supposed to be a Jesuit. He's supposed to be a high Jesuit. And yet he becomes possessed of the devil. And of course, at the very end of the video, Anthony Hopkins receives deliverance through a man who has complete faith in Catholicism. Not the God of the Bible, but Catholicism. And so you see the Jesuits bringing out their, you know, revelations through Hollywood. Of course, what does this film reveal? It reveals that the Jesuits themselves cannot cast out the devil. They can't do it. Even this Jesuit becomes demon possessed. They have no power over Satan whatsoever. And obviously it's disinformation and misinformation, because this man Michael, he eventually has faith in Catholicism and is able to cast out the devil. That's a lie. That's a lie. I believe the true revelation of this film is that the Jesuits are, in fact, you know, demon possessed. Possessed of the devil. And you have also V for Vendetta. I won't talk long about that, but you have V, who is actually, you know, Guy Fawkes. Guy Fawkes, who tried to blow up Parliament and kill King James and blow up the members of the British Parliament. And of course, that was brought out a few years ago. And you see in V for Vendetta, you see that V has a vendetta of vengeance. But that's really about the Jesuits fulfilling their oath of induction, which is to destroy every single Protestant government. And so you see, V for Vendetta is really about the Jesuits destroying the Protestant government of Britain. Now, of course, we know that today the British Crown rules over the Parliament. You know, the Queen of England, the Prince Charles, they rule over Parliament. But nevertheless, even though they're controlled by the Vatican, the film is truly about the Jesuits fulfilling their vengeance. And of course, V is nothing more than a symbol for Guy Fawkes, ultimately in the future, destroying the British government. That's the truth. So we have these Hollywood films, you know. And you see Luciferian symbols and signs all the way through these Hollywood films. Now, okay, I'll leave these links on the description section of the video. Look at these videos if you want to, and you'll see exactly what the Jesuits are revealing. But to move on with the message, the Jesuit priesthood of Lucifer, they are. And you can prove that, and I'm going to prove that in this video. Now, if you look at, let's go on to Freemasonry. If you look at Freemasonry, the ultimate doctrine of Freemasonry is the Luciferian doctrine. The purity of the Luciferian doctrine, that is that the High Masons, Those that are the 33rd degree Knights Templars, also 32nd Knights of Malta, they worship the devil. They worship Lucifer. That can't be proven. Lucifer is the all-seeing eye at the top of Freemasonry. Now, of course, you also have Jesuit priests that come on the internet and they bring up videos talking about, you know, Freemasonry and how Freemasonry has infiltrated the Vatican. They talk about that a lot. It's nothing more than a diversion to distract you from the truth that really the Freemasons are under the control of the Black Pope. They're under the control of the Jesuit general. But Jesuits, like, you know, Malachi Martin talked about how there was satanic covens in the Vatican and black masses to the prince of this world, Lucifer. I believe that. But I also believe that Malachi Martin was a disinformation Jesuit agent. It wasn't correct in a lot of his information. Now, this video is for people that research the Jesuits, people that want to know more. You know, I'm not going to explain a lot. I'm just going to give you facts, true facts, in this video. And pour my heart, really. Okay. The Jesuits do worship Lucifer in the Vatican. They do. The high Jesuits. There's an inner circle and there's an outer circle. Now, those at the highest levels in the inner circle of the, you know, Jesuit Curia in Rome, as in the Church of the Jesuit, they worship Lucifer. That's what they worship. But to those in the outer circle, they give them Catholicism. They give them Mary worship. They give them purgatory. They give them Catholicism and all of its false doctrines. It's a false gospel. They give them that to blind them, to keep them in the dark. That's what they do in Masonry, you see. When you enter the lodge, as in, you know, the first degree, when you enter as an apprentice in Masonry, you're blindfolded. And that's a symbol that you're really kept in the dark. And Albert Pike revealed that in Morals and Dogma, that really they're low initiates, you know. They're profane, they're ignorant. They're kept in the dark. That's what the blindfold means when you enter the lodge. That's why you're blindfolded. And they keep you in the dark. And they make you think that you understand the signs and symbols, but it's not until you reach the very high levels that you're actually brought into the Luciferian doctrine. It's the same with the Vatican. It's the same with the Society of Jesus, the Jesuit order. There are many Jesuits and many Jesuit alumni universities. And I say this, there are many sincere Jesuit priests of Rome. They're very sincere, you know. They're not all evil, they're not all in this conspiracy. But they're kept in the dark. This structure, this system, is the same all across the world. It doesn't matter if it's the Vatican Papal Knighthoods, or if it's Masonry, or even if it's, you know, let's talk about Mormonism. When you go into Mormonism, you know, people don't fully understand what they're involved in here. And eventually, you know, when they reach the top, they're taught that, you know, Satan is the brother of Jesus and so on, you know. But really, it's Masonic. That's right, it's Masonic. And at the very top is the Luciferian doctrine. All of these organizations are part of what's called Mystery Babylon, or otherwise what's known as the Beast System. And all of these organizations, it's the Luciferian doctrine at the top, guys. It's the Luciferian doctrine. Lucifer is worshipped. And I'll talk about the Black Pope now. The Superior Father General, or the Superior Jesuit General, or the Black Pope, he is the head of this Luciferian Babylonian world religion. Even those in Islam, they're Masonic at the highest levels. See, Masonry is worldwide, but even those in Islam, they are Luciferian at the top. The all-seeing eye controls everything in this pyramid structure, everything. Every organization, ultimately, at the very top, they worship the devil, they worship Lucifer. And the Black Pope is the one that oversees this global Luciferian conspiracy that will bring forth the Antichrist. You see, when people talk about the Antichrist, they have to understand that he will not just be a political leader. He has to be someone that controls all religions, all governments, all secret societies. He has to be able to oversee and control all of them. And there's only one man on the earth that can do that, and that's Pope Francis. But the subject of this video is the Luciferian conspiracy of the Jesuit priests of Rome. Now, it doesn't matter where you look. It doesn't matter what you research. Okay, let's go with the Bilderbergs. The Bilderberg Group was created by Prince Bernard of the Netherlands. He was a high Vatican Knight of Malta under the power of his Grand Master, ultimately under the power of the Black Pope. You see, the Club of Rome, exactly the same. Just another organization created by the Jesuits. You see, the United Nations. The United Nations was created by the Jesuits. And that's why they control every single member state. That's why the Jesuits control the President of the European Union, the European Commissioner, who's a Knight of Malta. There is a structure all across the world, and it's a Vatican-controlled structure. It's a Vatican-controlled system, whereby they control America, they control the United Kingdom, they control the United Nations, they control Germany, I mean, they control Russia. Vladimir Putin, he himself is Jesuit-trained. He himself is a papal knight of Rome. But you have to understand this. It's a Luciferian conspiracy. They worship Lucifer. They do. And the Black Pope is the one at the Church of the Jesuit that oversees this Luciferian global conspiracy. The Jesuits are Luciferian. That's what they are. At the highest levels. They're high provincials. And they control the cardinals, and they control the bishops. And these cardinals and bishops, they control the politicians. And these politicians are all high masons. This is the structure of this New World Order. It's Luciferian. And all of these hand signals that you see, like this one, or that one, or that one, or that one, they're all Luciferian. And they're all throwing these signals in our face. You know? It's in plain sight. It's there. They worship Lucifer. That's what they worship. The Vatican even has a telescope named Lucifer. I mean, come on. You know? It's obvious who they worship. Now, of course, Pope Francis and his high provincials in the Church of the Jesuit and also his bishops and cardinals, they deceive billions of Catholics by Catholicism. Of course, it's not true Christianity. And if you're a brother and sister in the Lord, you'll know this. If you're not a Christian, then I need to explain this. You have the Vatican deliberately perverting the gospel of Christ, deliberately bringing what's called counter-reformation. The Jesuits are counter-reformation. That's why they created the Second Vatican Council and the ecumenical movement, and that's why they even infiltrated the charismatic Pentecostal movements to bring the churches back to the Church of Rome, to bring them under the power of the Pope of Rome. That's called counter-reformation. That's also why the Jesuits created Mormonism, and they did. That is a high Masonic cult of Rome. That's right. Same with the Jehovah's Witnesses, the JWs. That also is a high Masonic cult of Rome. But it's counter-reformation. But the Vatican and the cardinals and the bishops, they deceive millions of Catholics today, knowing that they're destroying the gospel of Jesus Christ. It's a deliberate agenda. They bring a false Jesus. A false Jesus. Not the Lord Jesus Christ. Let me read something here from the Jesuit Oath of Induction. This is the Jesuit Oath. It's called the Extreme Oath of Induction, given to high-ranking Jesuits only. And read this. In fact, I'll read this part. I furthermore promise and declare that I will, when opportunity presents, make and wage relentless war, secretly or openly, against all heretics. So you have open and you have secret war. Against who? All heretics. Who are heretics? Bible-believing Christians. We're the heretics. And yet we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says, contend earnestly for the faith that was once delivered unto the saints. That's right. The true Christian faith. We that believe in the true Christian faith, we that truly believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, we are heretics. I'll read on. Secretly or openly against all heretics, Protestants and liberals, as I am directed to do, to exterminate them from the face of the whole earth, and I will spare neither age nor sex or condition. I will hang, waste, boil, flay, strangle them, bury alive these infamous heretics. You see, these Jesuits, they're of the devil. Who hates the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ? Lucifer. Who wants to destroy from the face of the whole earth the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ? The devil. What do you read in the Jesuit oath? I will strangle and bury alive these infamous Protestant heretics. Now listen to this. Rip up the stomachs and wombs of their women, and crush their infants' heads against the walls, in order to annihilate forever their race. Who does that sound like to you? The devil? Lucifer? I will rip open the stomachs of their women. I will crush their infants' heads against the walls. Demonic. Luciferian and demonic. And that's the Jesuit oath. My God, these Jesuits are going to face God one day. They're going to stand before the judgment seat of God. That when the same cannot be done openly, I will secretly use the poisonous cup, the strangulation cord, the steel of the poignard, or the leaden bullet, regardless of the honor, rank, dignity, or authority of the person or persons, whatever may be their condition in life, either public or private, as I am at any time may be directed so to do by any agent of the Pope or superior of the Brotherhood of the Holy Faith of the Society of Jesus. So you have the Vatican deceiving Catholics, blinding them to the true gospel of Jesus Christ. And you also have the Vatican bringing counter-reformation. And let me tell you right now, people say, well, that was in, you know, Ignatius Loyola created the Jesuit order in 1540, and, you know, that was hundreds of years ago, Alan. No, I'll tell you right now, it doesn't matter what mask the Vatican has on today, through the ecumenical movement, through the one world religion, or through the Catholic-controlled media that worship Pope Francis because he prays for the sick, and he washes the feet of the homeless, and he kisses babies and so on. Let me tell you right now, the Jesuit order are the most evil, dangerous, wicked, demonic society that's ever existed. And they still live by this Jesuit oath to slaughter and kill Protestants. That's why they will bring out their laws in the future, very soon, through the United Nations, not just against, you know, fanatical Islam, but against us. Against us, because we are fundamental Bible-believing Christians. Pope Francis has said that it's very dangerous, you know, for anyone to claim that they can have a personal relationship with Jesus outside of the Church of Rome. What is the Church of Rome? It's an abomination. It's the Great Whore. It's Mystery Babylon the Great. That's what it is, according to Revelation chapter 17. Let's continue in this oath. And I'm going to go down to the very end here. Where do you travel? Question. To the four quarters of the globe. For what purpose? To obey the orders of my general and superiors and execute the will of the Pope and faithfully fulfill the conditions of my oaths. Go you then into all the world and take possession of all lands in the name of the Pope. He who will not accept him as the vicar of Jesus and his vicegerent on earth, but be accursed and exterminated. The Vatican is still persecuting the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ, but they're doing it through infiltration. They're infiltrating the body of Christ. They're infiltrating the body of Christ today, and they're positioning their false prophets, who are Jesuit trained and high masons and Vatican Knights, of course, to bring counter-reformation, to really destroy the true faith of the Lord Jesus Christ, the apostolic true faith of the church. So they're bringing out other gospels and other doctrines. It could be the apostolic movements, the prophetic movements, it could be false revivals, it could be water faith, it doesn't matter what it is. We're being attacked on all sides, my friends. Ultimately, they will enforce the mark of the beast upon us, and that will be an international law to receive that. And only Christians will not receive that. And they themselves will be martyred. They'll be persecuted. Jesus said, "You'll be hated of all men for my name's sake." He even said, "Those that kill you will think they do God a service." We're living in that time right now. Right now. Obviously, the point of the video was that the Jesuits are Luciferians. I found out through research over the last few years that if you look at High Freemasonry, you'll find that it's controlled by Vatican Knighthoods. The 32nd degree is the Knights of Malta. The Knights of Malta is a Vatican Knighthood run by the Grand Master, who today is Matthew Feston. He's from Northumberland in England, and he's under the power of Pope Francis. And at the top you have the Knights Templar, which is Luciferian. It's a Luciferian degree, and the point is this. You see the all-seeing eye in the structure of Freemasonry. You see that same all-seeing eye atop the pyramid of the American dollar. You see the same thing. It's there. It's there. You know, the all-seeing eye is the symbol for the Jesuit general, of course, but it's also the eye of Horus, Antichrist brought forth. But I need to explain as I finish this video that I am not saying that every Jesuit is a Luciferian or worships Lucifer. It doesn't work that way. You have an outer circle, you have an inner circle. So you have Pope Francis, who is the Jesuit general. I know this. He is. He rules over the Society of Jesus. He rules over the Jesuit order and all of his Jesuit provincials from the Church of the Jesuit. And these provincials that are Luciferian, but those on the outside, those that are still Jesuits, they are not brought into that conspiracy, you see. They might be Masonic. They might have some knowledge of this structure, as in the Vatican worldwide global structure, even the papal knighthoods, but they're not Luciferians. It's only those at the top. Now, Pope Francis does control the world. That's why he goes to every nation. And that's why the media worships Pope Francis. That's why we see all of these, I'm not going to say apostate, because they're not apostate, because they've never known the truth. They've never known the Lord. Jesus says, "I never knew you." I'm talking about Rick Warren, Benny Hinn, Joel Osteen. You know, these ministers, they've never known the Lord. To come out and, I mean, Rick Warren, I brought a video out, I think it was yesterday, where Rick Warren is saying that, you know, he saw some news headline somewhere where, you know, if you like Jesus, you like the Pope, you like Pope Francis, you know. Make an equality between Pope Francis and Jesus, you know. Come on, you know. What are these men doing? They're deliberately deceiving the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ. They're infiltrators. They're conscious conspirators. They're trained by the Vatican, given funded by the Vatican, and brought into the Church of God in order to bring them under the power of the papacy. That's what's going on. Same with Benny Hinn. I call him Benny Sin, because he's a sinner. He's never known the Lord. He's not a saved man. But there's a lot I could explain. I don't really know where to... Okay, I'll continue the video. Regarding the Jesuit order, you see many symbols within the Society of Jesus. For instance, you have the black pope holding up the skull. Okay, he holds up the skull. And you see that also in Skull and Bones. You see it in many Jesuit churches. They have the IHS, and you have this, you know, skulls all over the churches, all over the walls. Even some where there's, you know, idols and graven images of Mary with skulls all over the walls. It's absolutely demonic. You know? It's a brotherhood of death. That's what it symbolizes. But you also see it in the tomb. You see it in Skull and Bones. You know, you see that symbolism there of the skull, you know, and crossbones. People say it's a Nazi symbol. No, it's a Jesuit symbol. The Nazis had that symbol of the skull on their flags, on their caps, you know. Skull and crossbones. The skull is the symbol of the Jesuit order, brotherhood of death, because that's what they are. Jesuit oath reveals that. I'll read again. I furthermore promise and declare that I will, when opportunity present, make and wage relentless war secretly or openly against all heretics, Protestants and liberals, as I am directed to do, to exterminate them from the face of the whole earth. That's what all these wars are about. That's what Nazism was. It was an extermination of Protestantism and Judaism. That's what it was. That's what communism was. It was an operation by the Holy Office of the Inquisition. And it's going to come during the Great Tribulation. You see, you have fascist governments today that are controlled by Rome, of course. They prefer fascism. They prefer dictatorism in that sense. So you have Adolf Hitler, who was trained by, you know, Carlo Pacelli, of course, later become Pope Pius. And you see in Nazism, you see Hans von Papen, you know, High Knight of Malta, signed the Concordat. You see Mussolini controlled by the Pope previous. You see the Vatican behind all of these dictators in history. Even Castro, my God, Castro, he himself was a Jesuit, fourth vow of the Jesuit Extreme Oath of Induction, or otherwise known as the High Oath of Induction. Castro was Jesuit trained from a Jesuit university, controlled by Jesuit priests. Same with Nazism. Martin Bormann was Jesuit controlled by Jesuit provincials. Same with Adolf Hitler. Same with Göring. Same with Hess. All these men. Joseph Stalin, he himself was trained in a Jesuit university. Now, if we look into politics today, of course, it's the same thing. History repeats itself. The Jesuit Order of Rome, they control the world in every generation. They position their Jesuit puppets and they control them. And you can prove that. Look at Joe Biden. He has two Jesuit degrees from Santa Clara Jesuit University and St. Joseph's University. Obama has a Jesuit doctoral degree from Notre Dame University. And I could give you such a list, but I'm not going to do that. I've done it in other videos, but every single politician today at the top, the ones that rule the governments, the prime ministers, the presidents, the heads of state, they're controlled by the Jesuits of Rome. Why do you think the Vatican, as a city-state, receives all of the ambassadors from every government and every nation and every prime minister and every queen and every monarch and every papal bloodline? The nations of the earth come to the papacy. Because it is the throne of all kingdoms. It's the all-seeing eye atop of the pyramid. I'll end this video now. There's a lot more I could say, but I'll bring another one after this one. But I'll talk about the Pope as Antichrist. God bless you. Thanks for watching the video. And remember, all roads lead to Rome, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth.